Hello everybody, Angelo Dube welcoming you back to the channel where we discuss all things aviation. Now, a few weeks ago, somebody contacted me and said, dude, can you please discuss the night rating in detail and also offer us an idea of how much this thing would cost? That's what today's episode is about. The night rating, what it requires, and the rough estimate of what the industry would be looking at should you want to do a night rating in South Africa. You recall that we discussed the night rating briefly in a previous video. You can check the link, it's up here right now. But what is it, this thing called a night rating? A night rating is a skill that you add on top of your existing skills. In other words, you get your license, your private pilot license, PPL, or your commercial pilot license, CPL, and you must have the night rating endorsed on top of those licenses. In fact, after your PPL, you're supposed to then do your night rating because it's a prerequisite for your CPL. In other words, the CPL will not be issued unless you have a night rating. It's part of the law in South Africa. So it's an endorsement on your license that says this person is now skilled and qualified to fly at night. This person has been tested, they've been trained and tested, they've passed the skills test, they can now fly safely during night conditions. How long is a night rating valid for? A night rating is valid as long as the license on which it is endorsed remains valid. So as long as your CPL or your PPL remains valid, your night rating also remains intact. Now, competency and residency is a different thing altogether because you must have done certain takeoffs and landings within the past 90 days for you to be able to fly at night. So even though it's still valid, you must also make sure that you're also current in your night rating as well. In other words, you must have flown and landed and you must have taken off and landed at night in the past 90 days for you to be able to commandeer an aircraft during or under night conditions. So in essence, the night rating is a rating for special purposes. It allows a pilot to fly at night. So you don't hurry to land before sunset because you're now competent. You can fly in the night with reference to your instruments, find your aerodrome and land the aircraft safely without endangering anyone. Apart from that, the night rating is one of those highlights in any pilot's training journey. You can rank it at the same level as your first solo when you first take off on your own and land on your own. It's one of those moments. It's also equivalent to your first solo cross country, you know, in terms of it being a highlight. It's as important as that. So what are the requirements for the night rating to be endorsed on your license? Number one, you need to have a valid pilot license. This will be your private pilot license. You must have that in possession already. Number two, you must be trained on night flying. In other words, you must go to an approved flight school and do your training there with an approved flight or certified flight instructor. Number three, you must have passed the theoretical examination, which is set by the CAA. Number four, you must have passed a skills test before you can actually have this thing endorsed on your license. Now, the number of hours required are that you must have undergone not less than 5 hours theoretical knowledge instruction. In other words, you must have been taught at a school for not less than 5 hours the theory of flying at night. Number two, not less than 10 hours of instrument instruction. Now, 5 of those instrument instruction can be done on a flight simulator. On a flight simulator. And then you must have done also 5 takeoffs and landings by night as pilot in control of the aircraft. You also need to do a dual cross-country flight by night, the length of which is 150 nautical miles with 2 away from base full stop landings. So who will do your skills test for the night rating? It's done by a grade 1 or grade 2 flight instructor, not just anybody else, but a grade 1 or grade 2 flight instructor. And you will be required to do 3 takeoffs and landings by night during that skills test. And there's an instrument component to the skills test, so there'll be a bit of instrument flying involved as well to test your capabilities and skills of flying at night without, you know, visual contact. What are the estimated costs of doing a night rating? The fee breakdown I'm going to give you now is an estimate based on, you know, what obtains right now in the industry in terms of costs. You need 5 hours dual instruction. That's the bare minimum dual instruction. Say on a Piper or on a 172, that's going to cost you roughly 11,500, because if you're working with an estimate of 2,300 per hour on 172, says now 172, then you are likely going to come up with about 11,500 on those 5 hours. These are conservative estimates. You may need more depending on how your uptake of the training is. You will also need 5 hours dual instrument instruction on the flight simulator, because remember we said 10 hours instrument instruction. So 5 hours will be in the aircraft itself, and then 5 hours will be in a simulator on the ground. Now, depending on how much the school you get charges, let's take a going rate of say 1,100 rand. That would set you back about 5,500 rand just for the instrument flight instruction on the simulator itself on the ground. Now, the next component will be your 3.5 hours of a dual instruction, dual night flights, which let's pack them at 2,300 as well on a 172 or on a, let's say, a Piper. Now, that would set you back some 8,000 rands or so. The total of those three components I've just listed will take you up to 25,000 roundabout. Add exam fees for CAA, and add other miscellaneous fees that you may come across as you do your training. Let's give a ballpark figure of say 30,000. So that's basically an estimate of how much the night rating training should cost you. Well, I hope you enjoyed that short video on the night rating and the likely costs for pursuing this rating after your private pilot license. Do click the like button and subscribe if you haven't done so, and thank you for those who have subscribed. The channel is growing. With that, you'll be able to reach out to more aviators out there. And remember, with every hour the cockpit beckons, keep adding those hours, whether it's through your exams or through studying for your exams or writing them or through actually pushing your hours in the cockpit. Every hour takes you closer and closer to your goal. Until next time, I am saying to you, stay warm, keep safe, till you again. Signing out.